Now, 2016 is going to be another exciting year, but it is not going to be an easy year if you're going to be working alone. Now, the next speaker will be up here to share with you how we can work together as one voice, one Propnex, and his topic is Top 10 Communication Tips to Reconnect to Old Clients and Get Easy Sales. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands for Bobby Sim!
Shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Okay, I understand that now it's about, 3:45. Some of you are getting sleepy, am I right or not? Yes, I understand, alright. So I know you guys are sleepy, but it's okay. Just bear for a while, maybe 30 to 45 minutes. Alright, so what's going to happen next? Can I just ask a question? Anyone here serve buyer? Raise your hand. Anyone serve buyer and got betrayed by your buyer? Anyone serve buyer, halfway buyer, run away, jabo? How do you feel? Good or no good? You feel good? Okay, awesome. What if there is a technique that you can get exclusive from buyer? Who wants that? Say I. One more time. Who wants that? Say I. Okay, this is not within this topic. Okay, it's going to be a bonus topic, but of course, in consideration, if only I can finish my topic on time. So how can I finish my topic on time? Simple. We have to follow my instruction closely. Say, follow instruction closely. Thank you. And how we start? We start off with this little balloon right here. Everyone have a balloon? Right, so upon registration, you are given a balloon. I want everybody to take out the balloon now, quick. Okay, next, I want you to blow the balloon. All right, I want to inflate the balloon. Okay, and after you inflate, I want you to pick up the marker and to write your name and your handphone, something like this, as you can see on the screen now. All right, I need everyone to do this. Okay, who don't have a balloon, raise their hand. Okay, let the staff come back to you. Whoa, 这么多没有. All right. I hope I can finish this exercise within 7 minutes. Okay, staff, could you please help me with the marker? Thank you very much. Those behind, do you have balloons? Okay, I want you to tie a knob. Okay, write down your name and especially your handphone number. It has to be very clear, all right? Oh, 恭喜发财. All right. Don't need to be too big, okay? Reasonable size are okay. Can I have some music? Some music. Those who don't have a marker, you can try using your pen. All right, write down your name.
Come on, check your body, baby. Do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Feel the rhythm of the music getting stronger. Don't you fight it till you try to do that conga beat.
Another 30 seconds, huh? For those who are ready.
You
Okay, next. Okay, those are ready. Say yay! Very nice. Okay, so what's going to happen next? Okay, imagine this balloon. Okay, these are all the listing you have. So what you want to do now? You want to sell away, correct or not? You want to sell all the listing away. So when I say the count of three, I want everybody to take the balloon and throw all the way up. All right. So by the time the balloon goes up, when they come down, you see another balloon, take and throw again, and keep on throwing. And we do that for 15 seconds. Are we ready? Are we ready to sell off all our listing? Yes or no? Do you want to sell all our listing? Yes or no? Right, count of three. 3, 2, 1, sell! Take and throw again!
Any longer, come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer.
Very good. We will sell all our listing by 2015 and a good start at 2016.
Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer.
All right, time's up. Now everybody, I want your hands. All right, everybody lift up your hands. No balloons on the hand. No balloons. Everybody just lift up your hands. Everyone sit down. Sit down, everyone, just sit down. Okay, don't worry about the balloons, don't worry. Just sit down. No more, stop. That's what I will do to my daughter, don't do that. Okay, now hands up, everybody, hands up. I want everybody to fold your arms. Your favorite position wherever you go. When you go to a show flat, you fold your hand. When you listen to an instruction, you fold your hands. Correct or not? This is the most comfortable position. I want everybody fold your hand, come on, help me. Okay, just be the most selfish person in the world. Just be the most selfish person in the world. So what's going to happen next? In the next 5 minutes, this is what we're going to do. You are supposed to go and pick up one balloon. If the balloon is not yours, I want you to throw out again and look for your balloon. Remember? Okay, just pick up, oh, it's not Bobby, so throw and look for the next one until you find your own balloon. Alright? No fighting, huh? Remember, huh? You are not supposed to take someone else's balloon. Ready, go. 5 minutes, let's go. If it's not yours, throw away. Look around. Try to look for your own balloon. You have to walk around because there are balloons behind. Alright? Walk around, don't stay. Stay in your comfort zone. Stay all you want. You are not allowed, only pick up your own balloons, all right? Take balloon only belongs to yourself. It's not yours. Don't care. All right? It's not your own balloon. Don't care.
Do me a favor. I'm down for Hassan. I collect Zuhu and Hassan.
All right. Music down. All right. Now, everybody sit down. Don't worry. If it's not your balloon, put it on the floor. Just sit down. Everybody, come. Guys. Help me. Sit down. Come on. Now, can I just ask one question? Guys, I need your absolute attention before I say this. Hello, Pronexian? Shh. Okay, stay. Okay. How many people managed to get back your own balloon? Raise. Wow, just now I see 80%, now only 20%, you know. Okay? So, only it's quite little, so there are still a lot of balloons on the floor. Okay, guys, I need your attention. Hello? Okay, next exercise, very simple. We'll do the same thing again, but this time round, the music not so loud. This time round, if you have a balloon, good. If you don't have, pick up one balloon, regardless from who. I want you to call that person, and pass to that person. Are you with me? Regardless, call that person, phone that person, or pass to that person. Is it okay? And let's do this for another 3 minutes. The time starts now.
There are still a lot of balloons on the floor. All right? Everyone, pick up. Stand up. Everybody do your part. Just pick up one balloon. Everyone do your part. Those behind, come on. There are balloons. Pick up. Do your part and start calling the person. All right? And pass to the person who needs the balloon. Okay, very good. Tell them your position, where you are. What is the name? What is the name? Anna, okay. Hassan, have you got back your balloon? Hassan, who wants to get a balloon? Stand here, I'll announce your name. Hassan, where are you? Is that your balloon? She found good. Okay, stick to the balloon. Good job. All right. Hassan, who wants to find a balloon? Give me your name. I'll shout for you. Come on, guys. Hassan, your balloon. Cannot. Okay, what's your handphone number?
9271-7142.
Hassan, everyone holding his balloon. 9271-7142. Hassan, anyone holding these balloons? Okay, thanks, brother. 10 seconds. 5.
9-6-9-6-8-5-9-8.
Colin. Anyone holding Colin's balloon? Come to the front. Start calling your friends, all right? Okay, last 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up! All right, who managed to get your balloon? Raise your hand! All right, good job, 50% more. Round of applause to everyone. Okay, guys, everybody, go back to your seats and hold your balloons. All right? All right, in the next 15 minutes, I need your 100% attention. Would that be okay? I need your attention because I'm going to deliver some very important message for those people who wants to do well in 2016. Whatever I'm going to say only works for those who want to do well in 2016. And in 2016, you don't want to do for the sake of doing. You don't want to work for the sake of working. You want to bring money back home. And because of this, I need your cooperation. Right? Now, let's look at this event. So, at first, when I ask you guys to throw the balloons, is it difficult to find back your own balloons? Yes or no? Why? Because everyone is individual. You do yourself. You cross your hand. That's your best body language. This is the most comfortable position. It's not my problem. So when you don't give, what happened? Nothing happened. But on the second part of the game, I changed the rules. What did I say? Pick up a ball. A balloon, regardless is from who, regardless, and start calling and pass it to that person. Can I have a raise of hand who received a balloon from someone? Okay, now ask yourself, do you feel good when someone gives you back your balloon? Yes or no? Exactly. So the power of giving is a very, very important energy. And when you receive from someone, what do? You pay it forward. You will pick up the next balloon and start to call each and everyone. Now, just imagine if the company works as a whole. So in 2016, why is it that there will be people who do well, but there will also be people who don't do well? It's because of this, the power of giving. Now, are we giving enough to our clients? Are we giving enough to our agents? And are we giving enough to ourselves? So in 2016, are we going to be a typical agent who only look after ourselves? This is something to think about. Because the game has changed. I remember during the good times, okay, 05, 06, 07, hi-yo, selfish is the way to win. Because why? Market no stock, everything rushing.
We betray one another. But back then, the one who do the fastest paperwork will win. Remember? You don't even need to know policies. You don't even need to know calculation. Just follow the system. But those days were over. No more. So in 2016, it's important for us to keep on giving. And these are the things we should be giving to our clients, our agents. And I'll just very fastly go through. Number one, we should give service. We should call our tenants. Hey, you know something? Hey, can I give you a service of a tenancy renewal? A one-stop service center. Because in the past, you are just someone who do a tenancy agreement. Tomorrow, you say, it's not my business anymore. You walk away. But this time around, you tell them, I will be looking after your property in the next 2 years. Are we giving education, financial positions, profile planning for our clients? Example, do we go to our customer and tell them, I will tell you how can you grow your wealth? Understand your financial position. Do you really know if you sell your HDB, how much you'll be getting back in terms of cash and CPF? Are we reaching out to tell these people? Next, care, concern, and love. When you talk to your clients, do you give them care, concern, and love? Do you tell them, you know something? I'm concerned if you don't buy, inflation will swamp out your savings. During birthday, do you send a greeting card? Are we giving enough? Last and not least, hope and possibility. Now, when you close something today, or maybe some of you do restructuring, refinancing, or you know, you restructure their profile, you have an experience, but are you telling other of your clients, hey, you know something? Recently, I did a restructuring package for one of my clients. And because of this, now they're owning two or three properties. I'll be more than happy to share the experience with you. Now, the other one, fire sales. Question, how much do you know about the fire sales in the market? Which are the good deals? Now, if you do see any, what do? Do you keep it to yourself or you got to call a client, oi, now I got something you must look at. Because this is the one product which will make a difference. Like example, High Park Residence. Wow, their studio is really very cheap. Alright? So, are we giving enough? Then, when we give, remember, we need the pride when delivering the responsibility. When we give. So, we give what? Personal responsibility in delivering excellence. When we give the best. Because why? Just imagine, if we don't give the balloons which belong to someone else, nothing will move. Alright? Next, we make a living by what we get, but we make a life in what we give. These are really, really important messages to each and everyone. Alright? So, let me give you an example. This guy, Herianto. Herianto actually was from another company, recently joined Propnex. So when he came over, he was sitting with a pool of very rich investors, a lot of money on. But the problem is, he's not giving. He's not giving education. He's not giving information to everyone. He has this mentality. If people want, maybe he will just come to me. So he stopped giving. So after coming on board to Propnex, because of the convention, he realized that, wow, there are so many information I should be sharing with my customer as well. So what did he do? If I remember this story correctly, one of his Indonesian clients just came to Singapore just for what? Holiday, only holiday. So from there he said, hey, I tell you something, nowadays a lot of people are using certain methods to buy properties. And do you know these are very, very good deals? That's all he did. He started to share 1 or 2 hours. And after that, customer feels that, not bad, not bad. Bring down the show flat and he closed. 65,000 within 1 week after crossing to Propnex. Round of applause to Herianto. Many of you also have clients who are very rich, true or not true. The question is, are you telling them enough? All right. Next. Now you know, okay, Bobby tell me, must give. No problem, I give. But again, before I give, something will come. What is that? What is that on the screen? Fear. Okay, now you tell me, okay, fine, that's a good deal, but I am afraid to reach my old clients. Because why? Too long we are not talking. Too long we haven't been communicating at all. Or last time I ever put her in a bad state because of my advice. Oh, my customer used to scold me. So because of fear of people giving out on you, fear of the past, fear of going to worry what's going to happen next. So because of this, a lot of people, even they know what they need to do, but they are not doing. Do you have friends who are like this? Think about it. So fear kills hope. Fear kills dream. Okay? Fear can actually kill you. So the question is, now everyone has fear, including you and me. So how are we going to look at fear differently? Because now we know the game is about giving. So what can we do? Let me give you an example. Imagine this. What if someone you don't know start calling you? Oi, I will tell you one, there's a very good deal at maybe Bishan. Wow, this one fire sales, do you want to buy? If someone you don't know just call you out of nowhere, how do you feel? Are you worried? Are you scared? Who are you? Okay, this is happening. A very good example is sometimes you receive a call from banks. Hey, you know we got this special mortgage or a special mortgage or special loans you can get from the banks. All because you don't know that person, is you easily do what? I'm not interested and put down. Am I right? Yes or no? Now, question. What if the one who call you is not someone you don't know? Used to be a banker who does your mortgage. And he calls you, hey, how are you? Hey, this is Bobby here. Remember last time I did your mortgage? Yeah, yeah. Hey, just to check with you. You know, recently our banks, we have some packages. No, we give easy loans. Just wonder, will you be keen to look at it? What are the chances that you will reject them out front? Or what are the chances that you will at least listen to a bit? Okay, fine, I understand. Hey, how have you been? How's your daughter? So what is my message here? If someone who doesn't know you calls you, I agree, the rejection rates are very, very high. But what if there are clients you know, or you have done something good for them before? So let's say your ex-real estate broker who helped you to sell your house call you back. Hey, how are you? Kelvin, how are you? Hey, this is Bobby here. Remember last time I helped you to buy something? Hey, by the way, do you know now there's another new launch coming up? Do you feel better? Is there a need to be fear? Think in the perspective of the recipient. Do you think they hate you? Actually, in fact, no. Okay, how about this? An insurance agent will call you again 1 year later. Hey, how's everything? Hey, your birthday coming. Hey, happy birthday. Hey, by the way, that's an insurance policy. I think maybe you may want to review. Compared to someone who call you out of nowhere and tell you, hey, I'm calling from this company. You know something? We have a great policy on to sell to you. And of course, that includes a car salesman and also even your renovation contractors. But what is my message right here? If you are calling back your old clients, in fact, there's nothing to be fearful of. There's nothing to be fearful of because they know who you are. But the big question here is, why should they listen to you? And I'm going to tell you this. Who wants to buy original Apple watch for $200 original? Who wants? Raise your hand. Wow, okay, a lot, huh? See, here's the question. I don't know them. They also don't know me. But why is it when I flash this, who wants, and many of them raise their hand? Why is it so? Why? Because you understand the value of the iWatch. And you know I deliver something good for you. It's a good deal. Am I right? Yes or no? So when I have a good deal, when I give it to someone, the fact is, not many people actually reject you. So here's the question. When you meet your clients, when you talk to them, do you always have something good for them? Are you aware about the market? Do you know which are the fire sales? If you go to meet a consumer without knowing all these things, just go in, hi, my name is Bobby, I'm a real estate agent, I'm here to offer my service. Offer what? So the answer is, there's nothing to offer. And that's the part you should be afraid of, because they will say, okay, there's no topic, there's no communication at all. Nothing to talk about. Am I right, sister? So here's the thing. When you have the right product, it's fine. So that goes back, and then here's the truth. Do you have what your network is looking for? Are you reconnecting only for sales? If you are only recording your clients for sales, good luck. Because today, they are smarter than you. They have more time to wait. Because in their perspective, the market will drop. True or not true. So we know that these are actually the psychology they are feeling. So if we need to go into their world, what do? We need to reconnect them in a different way. And the fact is, people only hate you. And people don't hate you for who you are. It's only that you don't have what they want at that moment of time. Because I have so many life experience. A customer who hate me today. Next month, I put them a good deal. They say, you are my best agent. Because the fact is, when you have something good for them, it makes sense. And are you familiar with the market? Before I meet any customer, are you familiar with the market, the cooling measures? How is it affecting? Like example, like Mr. Muhammad Ismail mentioned, wow, where is the market trend going? You are sitting right there. Are you listening? Trying to internalize? Or are you there trying to be busy with your iPhone and hopefully to take Mr. Ismail's notes and pass to your customer and let them read and they hope they come back to you? Or you're someone who's going to do exactly what he did just now. Well, the market, there's a trend coming down 4.1%. If you can buy something 5% off the market price, it's a good deal. Number two, products. Are you familiar with the products? During the period where a lot of us were focusing in CD gate, good commission, we understand. So we know which are the star buy fire sales. We make comparison CD gate, 1,000, 7,000, 8,000 per square foot. What do we compare with? Dual, 2,500, 2,600. 2,500, 2,600, 1,000, 7,000, 8,000. In a similar location, is it a no-brainer? Yes or no? So question is, how familiar are you with the products? So when there is a product launch, when there's an architect briefing, are you there? So if you are not there, we have a concern right here. Because when you meet your customer, you will not know what to do. And you don't know what to recommend. A lot of people come to me and say, Bobby, hey, how to be a top producer? I tell them, you want to be a top producer? Very easy. First question. If I have 1 million in my pocket, what should I buy? If you can tell me now, or you tell me, I will find out for you. If you're going to tell me, I will find out for you, the chances you won't be a producer. But when I say I have 1 million in my pocket, you tell me, hi, yeah, that goes without saying. We should buy Principal Garden. Why? And you start to pitch. That's very important. So the rule of the game is to know what you want to sell. Third, the knowledge. How familiar are you with the ABSD, SSD? Restructuring, refinance. Now the new thing, decouple. Remember, we talk about, we can decouple the property. Buying under a trust deed. What is called buying under a trust deed? Meaning say you can buy a property under your son's name. Even daughter below 21 years old. So there are so many techniques in the market. The question is, how many do you know? Then you tell me, Bobby, no one teach me. In fact, these are open information. And we should be blessed when we sell Singapore property. Because Singapore is the country you get almost any information. From the bankers, from the lawyers, from the contractors, from the developer. Try selling overseas property. I can tell you, then you know what is called scary. Right? So, before you meet your customer, these are the three things. Are you familiar with the market, the product, the knowledge? When you know these three, and you start giving, the customer find values in you. When you know what you want to sell, and we talk about business from that point of time. Right. So, what is fear? Basically, they are just false evidence appearing real. Don't take fear seriously. Because when we are prepared, fear is nothing. Alright? Fear has two meanings. Forget everything and run. Or forget everything and chong. Okay? Face everything and rise. Okay, this one, I think we can relate back to where? The video Mr. Muhammad is now playing about the basketball guy. The last 2 seconds. Chong nia. Mian xiao ni zui. Now, next, this guy, one of our agents, but he's very shy. He said that, Bobby, please do not never show my face. But he's happy. At least I'm glad he gave me his testimonial. He was with Propnex. He left the company, left to another company. Promises. I promise you this. I promise you that. Promise. A lot of promise. And he has no grudges with Propnex. It's not that we fight. No, we did not. So he said, never mind. He just want to try. So he went over. For how long? Close to 1 year. After 1 year, we managed to reconnect. Then he realized, Bobby, I think what went wrong. So what did he share with me? He said that I lose my focus over temptation. Because I was being promised here and there, but it wasn't how they promised me. So when he came back, we didn't do a lot of big drama. All he did was come for a convention, listen to the speakers, stay aligned, and he understand the importance about giving. So he took the information, start calling his client, hey, I'm back to a resale market. So what, from this little exercise, he reconnect back a client who wanted him to sell his landed property, 66,000 square feet, 1.5% commission. Okay? And from within how long? I think he came back within 1-2 months, he closed already. Now, just imagine, if you don't have that focus, and you're being put by temptation, what happened? Right? So, I've covered the importance of giving. What can you offer to them? Is fear holding you back? And seeing fear is a different way. Now, the last one, very important. Top 10 reconnecting excuses that you can call back your old clients. Who wants to know the top 10 list? Raise your hand. This one's solid one. Because you don't need rocket science to understand this. And where did I get this information? Basically, through my experiences. And many of them, because I'm leading a team as well, so through the experience, we try and error so many, and I came up with this top 10. And number one, the next one I'm going to show you is the very, very effective way to reconnect with old clients. Are you ready? Ready or not ready? Yay! Hey, let's go. First one, children. Super lame, but super powerful. I tell you, no joke. Hey, hello, Mr. Lee. How are you? My name is Bobby. Oh, what happened 3 years ago? My baby, I just gave birth to a baby child. No one look after the kids. But now 3 years later, okay, ready, can go nursing school. So now I got more time. So the reason for me to call is to reconnect, and I'm all ready to serve you and your network. How have you been? Easy? Paise? Or nothing but the truth? How many parents here are facing this problem? Alright? Hey, no joke, huh? Many of the ages I know, just by using this excuse, they get tremendous results. So later I give you one last testimonial, then I'll tell you exactly. She and her husband used this technique and they achieved something they have never achieved for the past 7 years. So children is one of them. Next! You read the recent newspaper article. Okay, I think some of you might have seen this before. It's a very hot article, okay, in this Money and Me, Me and Money. So we talk about this lady, a Hong Konger, who actually started investing about, 10 or 14 years ago. And they believe that we need to do it early. So when you see an article like this, what do you do? Read, enjoy, and forget about it? How about telling a customer, hey, have you read the article recently? Well, you know something. In fact, I do have similar experience, and many of my clients actually took the same approach, and they are making a lot of money today. Why don't we meet up for a coffee? Share any existing current news. Next, if you attend a course, now here's my advice to you. Go out and attend all the free course, free financial course, free real estate course, free one, just go and attend. Because all these people come with different opinions. Now, one of the very powerful quotes I pick up from a financial course, he talks about this. Investment is no longer a luxury. Because last time we talked about investment, hey, sir, you got extra money, you know, let's invest. Last time it's like that, correct or not? Only when you got extra money, then you invest. Investment today is a necessity because there's no other way you can fight inflation. That's a very powerful quote. It's a super powerful quote when I talk to my customer. Investment, sir, now it's no longer about you got extra, you invest. You need because we need to fight inflation and many other reasons. And when they agree, I start to put up the point on what are the things I can do for them. And that's where they find value in me. And once they find value in me, whatever I recommend will make sense. Part-time to a full-time. Now, some of you have been a part-time agent, all very shy, don't dare to tell people, shy. But let me tell you, you are sitting on a pot of gold, but you are not approaching them. So, if you are a part-timer, recently you convert to a full-time, I recommend each and every one of you to write a message. Hi, my name is Bobby. Wow, finally, I can venture into real estate full-time. Currently with Propnex, focusing District 19 and 20. Give me your fullest support. I will look forward to hear from you. Something like this, so easy. Put it on Facebook, send it to a client. You got people who text you, congratulations to your new venture, good job. Walao siao, property agent is high to humanity zone, also have. Got people also reply you, walao, you never join me, also have. But here's the thing, are we reaching out? So this is also one of the very good reasons to tell them I'm used to a part-time, but now I'm converting to a full-time. Next, cooling measures, okay, updating them. Hey, are you aware about the latest cooling measures? How will this impact you? Now, when cooling measures come out, be the first one to reach out first. Don't wait until cooling measures. People talk about 3, 4 months, 5, 6 months, the other one 2 years, then you talk about this because it's old news. Next, new launches, condo, landed, whatever thing. Wow, there's a new launch coming. But if we know that it's a good launch, are we telling our customer, or we keep it for fun? Remember, network will not give you money if you don't give them something. Okay, a lot of people say your network is your net worth. It's only true if it is an active network. Next, okay, this one, true story. I've seen some people who say, okay, I can't do a lot of things because my grandparents are with me, my parents are with me, who requires some attention. So for 2-3 years, they are just stranded at home, very limited time. Okay, but of course, over the time, they realize that, okay, now I got more time. Because now my grandparents is taken care by someone else. So it's the same script. You say, okay, about 2-3 years ago, I'm actually personally shouldering all the... I need to shoulder to look after my parents, but now, okay, I'm okay really. So I'm here to serve your network. Next, share recent experiences. Hey, I recently closed a unit at Principal Garden. Oh my goodness, this is an amazing price. Do you know developer price it so affordable that a lot of people are benefiting from it? Okay? Hey, recently I did a restructuring for one of my clients who is an overseas, he's from overseas and he managed to get a good deal from developers. And I would like to share that experience with you. Next, invite to talks and seminars. Everyone here, we should be privileged. We should be so happy that Propnex is doing this for us. When there's a convention, send to your client because we are leveraging with good people, good platforms, and good companies. And what Ismail like to say, hey, let me close for you, just bring them sit here. And if you want more tips, let's say your customer is a HDB owner and very scared of the market, go to Ismail, Mr. Ismail, my buyer is here, very scared of the market. Wah! During the talk, he will deeply talk about HDB, don't need to be scared, HDB, don't need to be scared. Okay, so invite them for all these things. Next, recovered. Now, these are meant for some of my agents who used to have a long accident, car accident, or maybe some of them have a chicken pox. Then you realize that, hey, no, it cannot really. So if when you recover and you come back, it's okay to call back your network and tell them, hey guys, I'm back. Why 3 years ago I met a car accident? You know something? Now I'm back to serve you and your network. But of course, you need to have a product. So these are the 10 reasons that you can use to reconnect with old clients. And a lot of them are proven before. And let's go back to this one, okay? Antia and Alex, Alan Yong. Simple, husband and wife with a kid about 3 years old, just like mine. Using the same technique to call, hey, you know something, last time my children is young, but now they are ready, so we put up the childcare, and I'm here to serve you and the network. They closed in the month of October, a six-digit income within 1 year. 1 year, huh? One month. So this is something they had never done it before for the past 7 years. And again, when I ask them, so tell me, what's so different about Propnex and another company? Why is it this time now you guys can make 6 digits within 1 month? The first thing they share with me is this. The minute I came over, I see something is called possibility. The possibility of making 6 figures. The possibility of the energy of people working together. The possibility of earning high commission. The possibility of teamwork. The possibility of customer willing to listen to us. And because of this simple stuff, they reconnect their old clients and one of them managed and want to buy something, I think worth about, 4 point something million. It's a 2% commission. All right? So, question. Okay, now I know the 10 reasons already. How to reach out to people? Correct? I clear my fear. Okay, now I understand the importance about giving. I clear my fear. I have the reasons. How to reach out? How to tell people? That's very tough. Number one, calling. If you understand what I say about the fear, remember, no one hates who you are unless you got nothing to offer them. Calling. Next, events and gathering. Okay, house party. Please go. Baby shower. Please go. You go there and you don't talk, better than you sit at home and keep quiet. No joke. That's the truth. All right. Now, next one, very important. Write a personal letter. Hi David, how are you? Remember 4 years ago I buy the property. How have you been? Oh, I know it has been so nice. I talked to you. Oh, just to give you some market updates. My daughter is 3 now and to tell you that I'm ready to serve the network. Let's connect. Send a personal letter to them. 1 week once, 1 month 4 times, enough already. Because can I ask you, touch your heart. If you receive a personal letter today with big influence of social media, do you take the personal letter more seriously? Yes or no? A lot of people take social media so fast. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Email even they don't read. But a personal letter, I tell you, it melts their heart. So write personal letter once a week enough. Recap back the good experience you had with them. Hi, how have you been? Yeah, here's my photo. Here's my daughter. Doesn't matter. Because this one tested and proven. They will send you a message. Thank you for the letter. It's very nice to reconnect back to you. Then from there, you start house business. Remember the property I bought for you? Do you know you have appreciated more than 500,000? Many of my clients, customer has used that money even double and triple their portfolio. Why don't you do this? Since it's been a while, we catch up. Why don't I meet you up next week? Have a coffee, you talk about it. So number three is very important. And most of our people died. You know where? They only do 4 and 5. Group SMS, group mailing, group. Okay? I know the convenience about social media, but social media brings to the next level. It's called losing personal touch. Real estate is a people business. We deal with people, not house and not money. Because the one who owns the house is a person, the one who owns the money is a person as well. Real estate is a people business. So 2016, go out, touch them, and reach their heart. So these are the 5 ways, but 4 and 5, try not to use it. Okay, so that's all. So far, have you guys got good tips? Mr. Ismail, can I have another 5 minute treat? Okay, since you guys are so awesome, I will give you my promise about this extra bonus. Okay, just now when I started, I say this. Get exclusive to buy from a buyer. Y'all want that? Y'all want to find the reason, the lame, what I call the lame, funnier excuse that people will give you exclusive because of what I say. Are you guys ready? So because you guys are a good audience, so round of applause to the management. Okay, before I share this, let's go! When I meet a buyer, hey, Mr. Buyer, how are you? Hey, you know something? Wow, I want to help you to buy property. The first thing I say, do you know many buyers don't end up buying what they want? They end up buying things they don't want. Why is it so? Simple. Because when they talk to the agent only show them what they have, but not what you need. Simple. If I got 5 listings, I'll tell you these 5 are the best, these 5 are the best. Am I right or not right? Okay? A lot of listers are like this, wow, this 5 is the best. So the question here is, agent only show them what they need, what they have, but not what they need. But what is the reason? It's because agents are concerned. Some of them are concerned. If I pick up this buyer, I start to work for him, call every day, look out for newspaper, I'm afraid I may not get paid. Why? Betray. I'm worried. What if the buyer betray me? Hey, talk about this. We just got betrayed over $150,000. Commission. Our customer say, good job. Finally, okay, they give us 1 referral and they close direct with the developer. Commission, $150,000. We got betrayed. So because of these reasons, do you know many buyers are not getting what they want? But here's the thing. In order to find good properties, it takes trained eyes and a lot of disciplines to monitor job scope, even to pre-negotiate your case even before we go down. But it takes trained eyes. It takes professionals. It takes someone willing to wake up early in the morning. First thing, before even I brush my teeth, I will look at the newspaper for you. But now you understand, because of point number four, we are afraid. We are afraid to do that for you. So here's the deal, simple. A good network also plays an important part. Because who we know determines what listing we know as well. If I know the agent very well, negotiation is easy. If I don't know the agent, negotiation is really tough. So if you agree point five and six, that goes out to the point, we'd like to enjoy these services for free. And if you want, please allow me to introduce what is called the exclusive to buy. You follow this sequence. I talk about exclusive to buy, the benefits by exclusive to buy. But this not only applies for private property buyers, because in general, private property buyers don't pay commission in general. And this one is a proven system, because I got agents who've been doing this. Bobby, I got four exclusive to buy. After buy, I sell the property and buy another one. Long zong bi tang. Alright? So now if you understand this, number eight, just give me your support. Give me the exclusive to buy, let me work for you. It's same that when you work for someone, you want the employment letter. When you follow this sequence, the chances are higher. So with that, thank you very much and all the best in 2016. Thank you.